Care, do you love me too? Or am I just a friend to you? Kara, what's the problem?
There's a lot, Gian. A lot. I can't explain it.
I know you have a lot of problems. That's why I always want to be here for you. I want to help you, Kara. Kara, I want to show you how much I love you.
Cello, even if we're far apart, remember that I still love you. I love you very, very much. You know what, Lawrence? I still don't understand why you're doing this. I knew at the very beginning that it would come to this. How many days has it been, and how long do you intend to do this, huh?
Allison, I'm just doing this for my cousin, okay?
Really? Are you sure?
He's not answering my call, Mother. It's not like him at all. He doesn't just disappear for no reason. It's strange.
You're right, dear. There is something strange about the things he's been giving you lately. Look at this bottle here. It's just like what Lawrence used to give you before. Oh. Hold on a second. You know what? Maybe it's a sign that Romer will take Lawrence's place in your heart. I have an idea. Text him. He might text you back. Maybe he wants you to chase after him this time. He's trying to be mysterious.
Aren't you going to text her back? She could be going crazy right now because of your silence. Lawrence?
He texts her back.
What did he say?
Give it to me. What happened to you? Why did you suddenly disappear? Why aren't you answering my calls? Are you angry?
Here goes. I'm just giving you some time off so you can evaluate your feelings for me. Just remember that I love you, Cello, and this will never change ever, even if you choose to love someone else.
Hmm.
I want to see you.
Lupe. I'll do it.
Are you sure, Camilo?
Orlando, it's time to eat. This will be good for you.
Ernesto, what are we going to do about this? It's suddenly so hard to set an appointment with the governor. I'm starting to think he's avoiding us.
Don't be impatient, Frida.
Don't be impatient? What are we going to do now? What about the coming elections? Look, I know we have a hold on Monte Gracia, but we don't have the entire province of San Ildefonso. We badly need the endorsement of that governor. Listen to me. He has control over all the officials in all the towns in this province. In case you forgot, we need him to win!
Do you actually think I don't know that, huh? Oh, give me a break, Frida!
You know, this is all your fault. This is all your fault! If you hadn't turned your back on him, this would not be a problem. What, would he be avoiding you, Ernesto? Of course not!
That's enough, Frida. All your nagging and shouting isn't going to help us one bit. I know the governor. All he needs is a little sweet talking.
Is that so? A little sweet talking?
Mm-hmm.
Well, for your sake, Ernesto, I hope you're right.
Miss?
Are you Michello? Someone sent this for you.
Thank you.
Let's step inside. This way, ma'am.
Thanks.
Thank you.
hope Lawrence's plan works out.
Hello, Rumor. Rumor, is this some kind of a game? Why won't you answer my calls? Why aren't you showing yourself? Hello? Hello, Rumor. I want you to show up right this minute. Right now. I don't know why you're doing this to me. Rumor, I don't know how you found out about everything. It's too much of a coincidence. But whatever this is, it isn't funny anymore. I'm not enjoying this anymore. I'm sorry. You're probably thinking I'm spoiling your surprise for me. Please, Rumor. I'm begging you to show up. Talk to me, please. Hello? Rumor.
Nurse?
Sir, we agreed on 5 minutes, do you remember? Please take your medicine.
Nurse? Hello? Mother! Why'd you call?
Why not? Can't I talk to my son on the phone?
Oh, Mother, please. Of course you can. You're my one and only.
Really? There are no other girls?
Well, actually, there is. Didn't I tell you about her?
Oh, yes, of course. Shallow. Anyway, I just wanted to make sure you're okay.
Oh, I'm okay, Mother. And I hope you're okay, too. And take care, okay? Mother?
I love you, son.
And I love you, too, Mother.
Please try to understand. I'm your friend. I'll always be your friend.
I know I'm your friend. I am just a friend. All I'll ever be to you is a best friend. Nothing but a friend. And I'm so stupid to make the biggest mistake of falling in love with my best friend.
What about you? Should you fall in love with me, how would you tell me?
I couldn't tell myself not to love you. Lawrence.
Hey, Kara, where are you going?
I'll just buy some squid balls.
Okay, but hurry.
Four squid balls, please. Thank you. Look in. I'm glad you thought of doing this.
Kara, I'll get you out of here.
Look in. Didn't I tell you before that I can't just leave. I can't just do it.
Why? Don't tell me it's because of the dance competition. Kara, I don't believe that. I know you can turn your back on that. There must be some other reason. Is it GM?
Joaquin.
Kara, you're much too young. Besides, you can't fall in love with GM. You must not fall in love with the enemy.
Kara, what's taking so long?
I'm coming.
Stop this. I don't want to play games anymore. If you think this would make me fall for you, then you're making a big mistake. I'm having a hard time getting over Lawrence as it is. So stop reminding me of him, Romer.
Kara? Kara. About what happened last night, I just want to make it clear. Kara, I'm so confused. And Kara, I'm sure by now that you know that I love you. Kara, is this where it all ends? Kara, don't you love me?
Jian. Didn't I tell you before that I can't love you?
But Kara,
when I have to leave you soon. I'm not doing this just for myself. I don't want to hurt you, Jian. Don't want to hurt you.
Hello? Please stop this, Romer. Don't do this to me. I don't want to remember him anymore. I want to forget the pain that comes whenever I think about him. Especially now. Now that I'm beginning to fall in love with you.
Thank you.
Ma'am Shiloh, someone sent this for you.
Florence, you have no right to mess up with my life anymore.
Hey, this is for you. I know you also have feelings for him, so why avoid him?
Nanny.
Kara, it's not wrong to fall in love. If I were you, I won't stop falling in love with him. There he is. Over there.
Oh, Jean! Ouch! My goodness!
That hurts!
Jean! Are you okay?
I'm okay, I'm fine. You see? I knew it, Kara. I knew you care about me too.
Lawrence, you should give up. Why don't you call Romer? You should stop the charade. You're just making a fool of yourself.
You know, honestly, I don't know if what I'm doing is right. I'm trying to court Shiloh for my cousin, for Romer. Even if I admit it or not, it's reminding Shiloh of our past, of what we've been through together. On top of it all, I'm being unfair to my cousin.
Not just to your cousin, you're also being unfair to Shiloh. Most of all, you're being unfair to yourself. You'd better just do what you have to do, Lawrence.
Hello, Romer.
Hello, cousin. I'm glad that you called.
I'll be coming back soon.
That's really great news. You know what, cousin? You
see, I can't do this any longer.
What? Why not?
It's becoming too difficult.
But why, cousin?
But Romer, you'll be back soon anyway. Then you can continue doing it yourself.
Yes, it's true, but can't you do it a little longer? Look, cousin.
I know that it's too much to ask for you to court my girl for me.
But please, I just can't afford to lose her. And that would really kill me. That's why I'm begging you, please do it.
Okay, fine. Just take care of yourself, okay?
Of course, thank you.
You're a coward.
Hey. So where's your devoted suitor? Why the sudden disappearance? Maybe his mother warned him against seeing you.
What are you talking about? That will not happen because his mother isn't Dr. Frieda.
Must have grown tired.
Suit yourself.
Why are you so pissed? You must miss him.
Shut up. Mother Ebony, I'm leaving!
Hey, Shiloh, can't you take a joke?
Kara. Please. Answer my question. For the last time, Kara. After this, I promise I won't bother you again. I'm simply asking you to tell me how you feel.
Jian.
Kara. This is the last time I'll ask. Kara, don't you love me? Kara, please answer my question.
Finish this for me.
I'll take this.
Come on, let's go.
Okay. That's good. Let's present it to the client now.
Let me see.
Okay, if you see this drawing right here, it's a female form. Now,
wait.
Absolutely, we could win an award for this.
Okay, this is it.
I like your layout.
See? This is what we can put on the front page.
But I would change some.
Hello, SC Advertising.
This one.
Hello. Is this Shalos and Carlos?
Okay, I'll bring it to final.
This is she. Who's this?
This is Margaret Ledesma, the mother of Romer.
Do you know what time the meeting is?
Can we talk in person?
Kara, please.
No.
It's okay. I knew it. I was actually prepared to hear it. I was so sure of it.
Jian. I love you too.
Say it again.
I love you too.
I knew that was your answer. I was just putting on a show earlier. I knew it! Rosie!
Hold on, Jian.
Hey, no problem. All right.
I'm looking for Mrs. Ledesma.
Miss Ledesma? Uh-huh. Are you Shelo San Carlos?
Mm-hmm.
This way, ma'am.
Okay.
Really good. Miss Ledesma, this is Shelo.
Hello, Shelo. Have a seat.
Thank you.
Waiter, can you get her order, please?
Mm-hmm. Just a glass of iced tea.
Okay.
Thank you.
Shelo.
Why did you want to talk to me, ma'am?
Shelo, it would be best if I just get straight to the point. Romer doesn't know that we're here together. I have something important I need to tell you. My son has only a few days to live.
This can't be true, Mrs. Ledesma. This can't be.
I couldn't believe it myself either. I'm thinking that it's all a big joke. But it's true. My son has leukemia. It's on its final stages.
I didn't know. He never told me about it.
Because he prefers it that way. He doesn't want anyone to know. He doesn't want to be a burden to other people, especially to his loved ones. Shelo, I know that my son loves you very much. He talks so much about you over the phone. Even his uncle, who is a doctor, knows about you. You're the only reason why he wants to live longer.
Jean, I hope this stays between us for now. Don't tell anyone else.
Of course, I promise. You have my word. I know that you're afraid of Aunt Frida. That's the reason. Okay, you have my word, Kara. You don't have to worry. No one else will know.
You know, I really envy you.
Why is that?
I just got to thinking that I wish I had amnesia too, just like you. If that were true, everything would be easier. Because I wouldn't have to work so hard to not think about her. That way, I'd forget her. All those memories would be erased.
You know, you're a really crazy person. Having amnesia is not the solution to your problem. Oh, by the way, Paul and his friends, how are they? Are they still bothering you?
No. I'm pretty sure that he's busy with their campaign. That's good news, isn't it?
Right. Elections are just a few days away.
I know. That's why Romer must come back soon. So I wouldn't have to court Shello for him anymore. Because it's disrupting my plans for the elections.
Here we go again. I'm getting tired of that.
Mrs. Ledesma.
Shello. Just call me Aunt Margaret.
Aunt Margaret, why does it have to be Romer?
I don't know. Even I ask myself that question. I don't know why. My only wish for the moment, Shello, is to just see my son happy. Because my son deserves to be happy.
Yes, you're right. Your son is a very good person.
I don't care if we exhaust all our resources. All the money we have between me and my husband, I don't mind. I just want my son to be happy. But I know that no amount of money can make Romer happy.
Aunt Margaret.
Shello. My son's happiness is in your hands now. I'm begging you. Shello. Please love him back.
Aunt Margaret.
I know that it's not your obligation. And you can't pretend to love someone if the feeling really isn't there. But tell me honestly, Shello. Is it that difficult to love my son?
I've often told myself that I'm very lucky to be loved by Romer.
But don't you love him, Shello?
But Aunt Margaret, I'm sorry, but it's all too sudden.
I understand.
Jin, how will we ever finish if you're like that?
And who told you that I wanted it to end? Never. Because it'll be you and I forever.
I hope so.
What did you just say?
Oh, it's nothing. I said, let's just enjoy every minute together. Because we don't know when all of this will end.
You know, Kara, I've always noticed this. You always sound like you're going away or something.
think too much. What I only need to say is, of course I can't cook for you all the time. All I mean is that you should also cook for me sometimes.
Oh, is that all? You got me worried there. Come on, let me do that for you. I'll finish that.
But there's no need because it's almost
done. No. I'll do the final touches, so it'll be special. Because I'll do it out of my love. My love. Okay? I'll take care of this. Trust me. My main ingredient is love.
Hey, that's enough. What are you driving at, Ernesto?
Governor, I'll get straight to the point. I want to run again. I'd wish to receive your blessing once more. I would like to accept your offer to endorse me as your candidate.
Okay, let the roosters rest. Ernesto. It's still too soon to discuss the elections. I still have a lot of time to evaluate whether you're a good candidate or not. I'll take my time.
So you'll continue courting her?
Yes. I feel sorry for my cousin. I wish for Shiloh to finally give in. I want to get this over with. It's taking too long.
Hi, Shiloh.
Hi, Shiloh.
Hi, Shiloh. Hey, what's wrong? I know she looks kind of bothered.
My son has leukemia.
Isn't she still gay? Hi, Shiloh.
What's wrong with her?
Shiloh. I love you, and I want to grow old with you.
Hi, Shiloh.
Shiloh, I know that my son loves you very much.
Rumor.
Ma'am, here he is, ma'am. Excuse me.
Romer. Son?
Mother!
Promise me you won't get mad at your Uncle George. Because he has told me everything, son.
I'm sorry, you know, I don't want to bother you. Does father know?
He'll be going to Singapore tomorrow from Spain. I was so worried, I just had to get home. You shouldn't have gone through this alone, son. Why didn't you tell me? Son, is that Shiloh?
She's a very strong woman, you know. She's like you. I don't want to die, Mother. You know, not now. I want to live for her, Mother. I want to make her happy.
Hello, Aunt Margaret. I have to see him.
Shiloh, he doesn't know you're coming. He doesn't want anyone else to find out.
Aunt Margaret, I won't let him see me.
You know, Mother, when I get well, and when I get Shella to say yes, and promise you, we'd all go to Rome. You know, Mother, it has always been my dream to be married in Rome. Actually, you know, I don't care where I'm married. As long as Shella is my bride. She's the only girl for me. I don't care who I married. Mother, don't cry, come on. That's enough. I'm going to get well. You know, I'll get through this. You shouldn't cry, Mother. Mother. You know very well that I don't want to see the people I love crying. That's enough. Okay? What I want to do, Mother? I want to shout. And I want the wind to carry my words of love to Shiloh.
Go ahead, son.
Shiloh, I love you! What is it, Mother?